Hello friends, here in this video we will see some of the common terms which are there in springs, and those terms they are called as terminologies used in springs. So here I will mention some of the terms which are used in the springs frequently. The first one is spring index . This spring index is given by capital C. It is equal to capital D upon small d. Here capital D is equal to mean coil diameter, unit will be mm, and small d is wire diameter. So spring index, the first term. Next is deflection. Deflection, it is, I can write it down, it is the distance moved by spring under the action of load. And deflection of spring, it is denoted by delta, and that is equal to load upon K, which is stiffness. The next term which I am going to define. This, its unit will be mm. So after spring index and deflection, the next term is K, which is stiffness. Stiffness, it is defined as the ratio of load to deflection. So that is stiffness. It is the ratio of load and deflection denoted by letter K, and it is W upon delta. And the unit of stiffness, since it is load upon deflection, load is Newton, deflection is mm, so it is either in terms of Newton mm or kilonewton mm, kilonewton per mm, Newton per mm, etc. Next, after stiffness, the next term is shear stress factor. Shear stress factor is denoted by K suffix S, and it is equal to 1 plus 1 upon 2C. Now here in shear stress factor, we are getting the relation between shear stress factor and spring index C. Next, after this we have walls correction factor. Walls correction factor is KW is equal to 4C minus 1 upon 4C minus 4 plus 0.615 divided by C. This walls correction factor is needed when we are designing the spring, because this takes care of the curvature of spring. Next, after these five terms, next is solid length. Solid length of spring. For that purpose, here I'll just draw a diagram to explain what is meant by solid length. When the spring is subjected to load, and because of the action of load, when the spring is completely closed, that is, each of the wire diameters are in contact and there is no gap between two wires, this entire length is called as solid length of springs. That is, solid length, it is the length of spring in fully closed condition. So therefore, solid length is equal to N into D. Here I have the formula. Where N is equal to number of turns of spring, and small d, that is equal to the diameter of this wire. In mm. After solid length, next we have free length. Here for this also I'll draw a diagram and explain. See, this is the free length of the spring. In short, free length means the length of spring in the unloaded condition. In free length, we don't have any load on the spring. This is denoted by LF, L suffix F here. And it is the length of spring in unloaded condition. And for free length, I'll write the formula. It is given by free length is equal to solid length plus maximum deflection plus 15%, that is 0.5 times of maximum deflection. This is the formula to calculate the free length of the spring. Now, after seeing the free length, the next terminology is pitch of spring. Now this pitch is given by the formula. It is free length upon N minus 1. Now when we are talking about pitch, it means that, I'll draw the diagram and explain this. Now suppose this is a spring. Pitch means if we are selecting a point on a spring, on one wire diameter if I select a point, then on the next wire diameter if I select the point at the same location, that is if it is at the center, this distance would be called as pitch. Denoted by small p. Similarly, we can select pitch on anywhere on the spring. That is, we can select the distance. Just we have to select a particular point, and on the next wire we have to select the point at the same location. So that will give us the pitch, and pitch for a spring, it remains same. That is, through the entire length, the pitch has to be same for a given spring. Next, after pitch, then I can say that for squared and ground ends, now what is the meaning of squared and ground ends? Springs, as we can see, they are made up of wires, means the cross section is circular. So when we will be placing this spring on a surface, there are chances that under the action of load, this spring, it can shift, it can slip. So to avoid the slipping, what we do, we just make this end squared and we grind it. So whenever we are having a spring, we have to leave two of the turns for squared and ground end, that is at the bottom and at the top for seating. So I'll say that therefore, for squared and ground ends, total number of coils will be equal to number of active coils plus 2. So when we are deciding that how much should be the total number of turns for a spring, that total number of turns will be given by number of active coils. Active coils are those which take part in deflection. Because when we have a spring, only the active coils will deflect. The coils which are there at the bottom, I can draw the diagram here itself. Like for this spring, here if I provide squared and ground end, then this spring will be fitted on this surface. Similarly, at the top, here I am providing squared and ground end for the seating arrangement of the spring. And now there are the slipping chances are less. So the coil at the top and the coil at the bottom, they are fixed, so they do not take part in actual deflection. So here I have these three coils as the number of active coils. So total number of coils would be the three active coils plus 2. So here I have total number of coils. The formula becomes N dash. Total number of coils is number of active coils plus 2. And this 2 we are adding for squared and ground ends. Next, after this, the last term which is left, that is deflection, is given by one more formula, and that is deflection is equal to 8wd cube into n upon gd raised to 4. This is another formula by which we can calculate the deflection for a spring. And here we need to know all these terms. So here W is the load on the spring. Unit, it can be Newton or kilonewton. Capital D, it is mean coil diameter in mm. n is equal to number of active coils, g it is modulus of rigidity, unit newton per mm square, and small d it is called as wire diameter. So here in this video we have seen the terminologies which were commonly used in case of springs. That is, when we are talking in terms of spring, there are some technical terms which are to be used. Started with spring index, second was deflection, then it was stiffness, shear stress factor, walls correction factor, then solid length, free length along with the formulae, pitch of spring, and then we have seen what is meant by squared and ground end, and at last we have seen deflection.